Yes, welcome back. The program now AS E DEY HOT, and it's still the hot, seriously, because Chukwudi still the studio, and Madam Natasha, Barrister Natasha, anyhow I won't call him, Apkoti still also the studio. And we don't look into the major stories that we play out over the weekend, but we don't delve into the Ajaokuta still issue, where we say, somehow, just as Chukwudi, the blood say some key leg, don't do anything, they enter and they come out. And Madam Natasha, they give us a lowdown of what really play out for the whole thing before we go for that break. So, Madam Natasha, continue from where you be stopped on top of this matter.
You know, say, I know they like when person they interrupt me, but I understand, say, your throat, they dry sometimes, say, one
thing. Exactly.
The water where you drink sometimes, just the fear, say, how you fit to your body if you take that water. Anyway, maybe we talk.
Okay.
I talk, say, that Ajaokuta, I can't discover, say, it dey more than a steel plant. Now, 43 different factories inside one.
43?
The time where they design, the time where the Russians designed that place, it was the world's largest steel plant. And presently, it stands as the fifth largest steel plant. And the largest steel plant in Black Africa. As at today, that plant where you see so is the first most ecological and environmental friendly steel plants. Make a break that thing down, because you know, so sometimes even to call the word, I had to like ecological and environmental friendly. That means we say that steel plant, it go to operate with zero wastage. That means we say when the engine, the big engine, don't remove all the, don't carry the iron or the rock, go put them inside, come remove the iron. The remaining thing will be, say, residue, where normally other plants go, they throw away.
And based on saying that dirty.
This steel plant, it go carry that residue, say, okay, what thing we fit get from this one? The biggest thing we fit get, but there's one thing where they call slag. That slag, all these obodo ibo that they use them do, any country we get steel, they use slag, do them road. That's how when you go America, you get some road where they move, they go things say na marble you there for. Not be cement that they use them more. Now starting they call slag. That one be the byproduct of steel. That means if Ajaokuta they work, our roads, we go get the best products for our roads. Not be this kind of way, you go build road today now, you will come to get pothole tomorrow. Nothing. The road go there like iron. That's the one thing when Nigerians know, say, with the miss. Number one, slag. The byproduct from Ajaokuta, where they produce for abundance. Now, after that, now, after they don't remove slag now, it gets some other things where it go there. If it make that other byproduct, if it they use to make paper pop, sugar, oxygen for hospital, that means all this one you hear say, baby don't die for incubator because they don't get oxygen. Ajaokuta as it stands now, it gets one unit inside it. We're going to trap oxygen, nitrogen, and all the kind of all the kind of different gases for different uses. That place, as you see now, if it produce battery water, it's where some special kind of machine. In short, for just imagine 43 different kind of things. That means if Ajaokuta they work today, Kogi states and other states around the supposed gates factories. From sugar plants to cosmetics to other paper and many other things. Apart from the factories where they use steel, first of all. And let me tell you, steel in our life. Steel, roofing sheets, construction pipes, construction roads, armored cars, bullets, when you talk about war weapons, everything, aircraft, cars, even for hospital, for kitchen safe. Cutleries, cooking pots, gas cookers, microwaves, all this one are steel. Look at the offices now. Stapling pins, everything you see alive around you, it is steel. That is why the world can't talk, say, the country where get steel don't enter different level. As a matter of fact, now steel, they rule the world, international politics. That is why now, make I talk, say, people go, they wonder, how come such a beautiful bride when Nigeria gets never born one Pekin. That bride said, don't they just stay like that. What is going on? Then we begin to, if you now look at it, make I tell you, I'm sorry to say this. You say me, I behalf for Ibo now, but like, me, I love the Nigerian side so much, and I love fairness for humanity. So may I go speak. The good thing be say, my own mama's side no participate for slave trade. So yes, the Soviet bloc no participate for slave trade. So I fit say talk, I fit get the opportunity to talk directly to the slave masters. What did they happen today for international politics? Made Nigeria understand, say, now different kind of slavery. They call them economic slavery, whereby some countries, the bigger countries, those countries where participate for slave trade before, slavery where they put chain, they don't come put invisible chains over our international domestic politics now. That means, say, these bigger powers, the Western countries, they like to maintain Nigeria and many other African countries as distant colonies. After they talk now, I beg my people, I know say some of these words, they tough, but mm-hmm. you get your phones, make you they Google them. Everybody should donate. Google Africa as a distant colony. To America, you can get some things, or to UK. You go see, say they just systematically maintain Nigeria and other countries, say, make it just be the material hub. Make it never too powerful. Make it not powerful, make it come the flex wings together with the masters.
For they follow their rock.
Yes! Shoulder. Now that one, they can't discover. That, like I tell you now, countries like UK, they don't get any natural resource. The only thing where you get is nuclear power. But what do they get? The brain to come the creation and tell you, say, oh, this is not good, this is too good, do this. They now, on America too, they go, they intervene into our domestic politics. Come they control nations, especially Nigeria, because Nigeria is the most populous country for Africa and the seventh most populous country in the world. That means, say, now we get population. The population in Nigeria now, it be like six countries in one. That is why they know they play with make Nigeria too great. So it was a systematic thing, no, you know, allow that Ajaokuta grow. Because the plan where they can't get before for this Ajaokuta, be say, that's the Russians, be say, when Ajaokuta don't grow, but don't kickstart, they could come make Nigeria the industrial hub of Africa. That means all these ammunitions, planes, cars, whether they manufacture for Europe, they will come to manufacture them here.
Yeah.
And what did they talk? Say, I know supposed to talk, but go talk them now. They say, them plan, the Russians plan to say, they go systematically prevent other African countries from starting up factories that Nigeria is already producing. That means say, if we don't produce weapons or bombs, or all of these things, they go just the player. Now, some America, they do. I'm not saying that, so they just say, no, if you want, patronize from Nigeria. Patronize from Nigeria. That is it. That means Nigeria was supposed to be the giant. That's why. And they decided, because at that time, Nigeria is not be the kind of Nigeria we be there. That time, when they planned this thing, Naira is strong past dollar.
But Madam Natasha, yes. No, we don't hear all these things. Just like you don't open what I call canker one. You don't expose a lot of things where this thing really, where they surround this particular Ajaokuta state issue. But then, where we can't get the fallout? Because recent, just last year, December, the minister of solid mineral, that's Oga Fayemi, come and talk, say, look, say he did disappointed. The fact, say we get Ajaokuta State, I know they work. Say him, under his government, I mean, under his own ministry, they go ensure, say, this thing revive. But then, where the fallout come day, why we never still fit, say, okay, we as a country, if other people say they will put on, but we will not agree, make we move this thing forward.
Make I just tell you one thing now. I like waiting that my uncle fire me talk. I call him uncle, my uncle, I love him too much, first, for one side. So, he get passion. But now, so many people when they come there get passion. If you check now, if you Google all the ministers, where don't come for that place, whether the minister of solid minerals, or you know, so the name don't they change. Minister of mine and steel, minister of this and the steel and everything. They're so passion. You see, 1,000 passion, you know, reach one action. You can have all the passion in the world. If you don't put action, now zero. And apart from that, one good action is better than 1,000 wrong actions. So make we break them down. Right action is more than 1,000 wrong action.
Yes.
And then one action is better than 1,000 intentions or passion. Simple. So what do we see now? Say, yes, this government get the mind to do them. Now, where did they fall out today? As these people don't they build the steel plant. Steel plant where they suppose, now only 6 years, they suppose construct them more. I love my Baba Buhari, but now the time where he just come do the first coup, that time where coup we bring him 1984, I be 83.
Where come out?
83. No, where bring Baba Buhari the first time.
Okay.
And now that coup come slightly give K-leg to the conclusion period. Because they start that steel plant in 1979. It's supposed the lead moment where they supposed hand over to the government in 1986. But when that could enter now, you know, say you can't change ministers, change everything.
Exactly.
That was another process. He can't stop him. He can't slow him. But after that, now they can't pick momentum again. Before you know it, now and that could can't happen again. So now that all this series of coup and change of government and change of processes, now you understand? Like now you see, as I don't, they flow with you. If somebody can't come out now, come and that person can't interview.
You will probably say won't start afresh again.
I go say, hey, that connection, that momentum can't break. So now that's important. And so now, when different governments come, they enter, and then the system come, they weak. Now, so the international bodies,
we continue to know
IMF, World Bank, come to tell the new government, you know what, kill that project, you don't need it. You know, it's too complicated for you. If you want steel, America say, you don't need to have a steel industry. If you want steel, come buy from me. Now, so UK can't talk. You don't need steel, send the Russians away. Before you know it, Nigerians can't stop till they pay their own money. Now, you can't, they get one point whereby these people they build and can't say, ah, make we just come out, go our country. But they say, no, we don't invest too much. So,
yes.
Me, if we live on like this now.
Now, we be saying
now
we lose.
Now we but you know what, exactly. We let them, make we use our own money, come in, put out, just near complete time for Nigeria. Now, in these people can't spend over $800 million that time. It's close to $1 billion.
That time.
The time they can't build and reach 98.8%. The
only it don't finish now.
At the time where these Russians leave this place for 1984, 1994, when they leave the steel plant, pack go their country, say, Nigeria, wahala, don't too much, oh, and I don't breach in our contract too much, so that we don't do our money. This side. The only thing. Where remain, where the Russians no do for that place, now to ignite, what did they call, the blast furnace. If you Google, anybody will Google the picture of Ajaokuta, you go see one huge machine like this, where for that place, that thing they run, they produce liquid steel. That thing, the reason why the Russians no start them, because they say, if they start them, the thing is supposed to work for 15, 20 years, non-stop. Because to stop them, and to start it again,
it will cost
too much. Now that thing, Russians can't say they can't use their own money, can't complete that thing, do everything, and say, you know what, Nigeria, we cannot start it now because it gets some raw materials.
We're supposed to enter.
And Nigeria, as they done, they complete them for 3 years. Oh, make I tell you now, 1994. Now when these people come out, since 1991, 3 years, every month they send letter. So the ministry that time, whether our minds are still or whether they call and sign, I know I said the name doesn't change. Say, please fix the rail track from Onneport to Itakpe to Ajaokuta. Make raw materials they come. We need it. 3 years old. No, but Nigeria. Well, I don't know who the minister was for that time. Nobody respond to that email. To any of their letters.
At all.
Every month for 3 years, they were reminding the federal government to build the infrastructure because if that infrastructure is not on ground and the raw materials cannot come, they cannot start it.
Madam Natasha, we go quick rush, enter inside this break again.
Okay.
When we go on that break, come back, we go step up the discussion.
Okay.
And the one we go enter now, as the thing they happen latest now.
Currently.
What will be the way forward? Because some people already come back and say, it be like any stock where you talk, where you carry this matter for head. It be like say somehow.
Monkey and dog say.
I understand. Yes.
When we go this break, come back. We'll discuss that particular one. Make we know whether. So whether your surname now Kaflechenko
or whether
you are Russian people.
Make we go the break. Will they come?
Will they come back? Welcome back to AS E DEY HOT. Ezugwu Chukwudi and Nkubi and our Ogbonge visitor, Madam Natasha Apkoti, inside studio. And we discuss all the action today we will carry come this week, but emphasis on the small chops we will carry come, the A to Z of the Ajaokuta steel mill wahala. She don't break everything down, don't start with as the thing take happen, reach the point where we say they're supposed to just on the thing, make the thing begin to work, make Nigerians begin to enjoy for inside our country. So, but we'll come fast forward and reach this period when we do so now. And we've been here, she say, okay, oh. And with everything we know happen, our people in the government, when they say they charge, there's a big book where they don't look this issue, they can't look say, okay, yes, this is where we are now. And we can't enter into agreement with Indians. This agreement we enter with Indians now, what will be the way forward?
This agreement where we enter with Indians, me, I see and say now one step forward, three step backwards, where we don't take now. You see, these Indians where we don't enter now, they say, not be the first time where they don't come from Nigeria. Now, the same Indians where gone vandalize this same plant, where late Yaradua come terminate the contract, say chase them come out, even call it EFCC, say make arrest them. When they know if you come Nigeria, by the time where President Yaradua, they are alive. Now, when he can't die, now they can't take Nigeria, go court.
You sure say this Indian, this particular one, maybe not the one where don't born again.
Wait
because some people, they run from PDP to APC. and they change.
You know, say they talk, say leopard, not they change in spots. And then out of all the people waiting for Nigeria, and I say that now that won't be the best deal. Because make I tell Nigerians how that deal happened. Now, after these Russians don't go now, then our president Obasanjo come say he won't privatize the Nigerian asset that time. If you remember now, the 2001. So he can't call, you know, the thing can't get K-leg, big K-leg, or like many things. That is our national assets now can't enter some people where they close to harm, where they no do due process. So these people not even qualify.
They follow backyard.
They follow backyard, self, underground, say they can't enter these Nigerian assets can't enter inside the hand of people where not even do any steel plant for the world. Imagine say they give the biggest steel plant for the world that time, can't give them somebody will never even
practice anything
here. Now, so those people no come no waiting to do, they can't bring the Indians, make your head. Even the Indians where they bring, self, not be the original. You know, say some Indians say they good. Like now, the person who get this business, they call him Pramod Mittal, the one for Nigeria. He big brother called Lakshmi. That Lakshmi a fine man. In short, say, if not Lakshmi Mittal, they, this president, don't enter this agreement with, I go just relax and sleep safe. But this kind of brother, we never get, as of today now, this global infrastructure now, he not get one successful business all over the world, though. I'm telling you.
Everything when they do not trial and error.
I tell you, which trial and failure. Trial and failure. Now you know it's a trial and error. I beg. Listen, this same global infrastructure, my people, I beg, we're not going to get phone, please, eh? Make una Google Global Infrastructure Holdings Limited Businesses. Or, Global Steel Holding Limited Businesses. You will see. This same person, he carry, at the time where he get a Ajaokuta, he can't enter Bulgaria. Bulgaria can't carry their biggest steel plant where this steel in Russians to build. That steel plant for that time, they employ 5,000 people. This man, 2005, paid $110 million to run, acquire them. Within 1 year, the man ran it down. As the man, as this same global infrastructure ran down the business for Bulgaria, the man can't run come out for the country. But you know what's in Bulgaria? Do you know something about Bulgaria? Not be like Nigeria. They come arrest the MD. The MD of that company now, they call Alexander Tomov. Make everybody Google Alexander Tomov, Bulgaria. You go see. The man, after they arrest him, come arrest every other person. We make that deal. We do that deal for this global infrastructure. Yes. They are presently serving 9 year jail term. In 2011, they sentenced them to prison. That's a country that takes charge of, that knows how to treat criminals. Now I can't see, say, maybe my dear uncle fire me talk, say, they find themselves between the devil and the deep blue sea. Say, be say, these Indians can't carry Nigerian assets, go court, say, President Yar'Adua terminated it. Say, the court can't, they can't for court 8 years. So the only way to free Ajaokuta, because these Indians, they can't smart, so they can't tell the court, say, until you resolve, we're not going to release Nigeria, Ajaokuta. So make Nigerians know, say, for these 8 years, in this global infrastructure, they held hostage your resources.
Our own resources.
Our own resources. So now a company will not even get face for India. So now Ogafa and me say that's the best resolution. Say, because right now, as of today, Ajaokuta is free. Back to the federal government. Because before all these 8 years, they never did free to the federal government. But now I can't say, is that the best deal we could have done? A whole giant of Africa. You come allow one small country, one small company for a country to come and hold you, come manipulate the terms and conditions. Come carry Itakpe. And make I tell you now, Itakpe is the heartbeat to Ajaokuta. Without people, some people say, make we just manage jam now. It's just 7 year contract.
Manage.
Do you know what in 7 years be?
Manage.
Make I tell you now, Ajaokuta is nothing without Itakpe. It be like, say, make I give you one fine Mercedes, can't remove the battery.
Or say
I give you Mercedes, say, make you go from here to Lagos. I can't give you 20 liter fuel. Now you be say, if that management, I'm not sure whether this global infrastructure now fits, operates Itakpe to the capacity where it go supply Ajaokuta all the iron ore it need. Because you see now, I tell you, say, now 43 factories in one. Yes. That means the amount of iron ore it needs them, now 247.
Consistently.
You know the need for, once they start that engine, for 15, 20 years, you know one here say no light, no, or you know work something. And then, now, make we just ask the government, say, I hope my Uncle Fire and me don't sign agreement with these people, say, not been late we do before. We no one here say 1 minute iron ore no day. Or say they can't do the thing where they do before. Say they can't tell Nigerian government say they know they tap iron ore. Meanwhile, every night trucks go they move, come out for our place. Yes? You don't hear about the Ogamnana crisis, where it happened. That's so they come, they carry the trucks, they steal all these Indians. Every night, trucks have iron ore and equipment go they steal. Now in the community come across them. You see, how are we sure say we no go fall ourselves into the same trap? Make this company, make we do due diligence on them. And make we pay, say, as I say, make una show us your track record for the past 5 years all over the world.
Madam Natasha, you know, go vex. We get somebody where they call us all the way from Yola, Oga Obiora. Oga Obiora, good morning and welcome to As E Dey Hot.
Yeah, good morning, Chukwudi. Madam Natasha, good morning.
Good morning, Oga Obiora.
Nkubi, good morning.
Yes, sir.
Chukwudi, I thank you now for this year, our Ogbonge visitor. This one is August visitor, the long one. And you know, all the point that she's bringing out is exactly what we are seeing. But the main problem is the thing is in conjunction with cities. Because when any other government comes in, the other past government would not like to give them the full details. This is why we fell and follow like this and make it. People will be trying to beat
the struggle, yeah.
And before you know it, everybody will fail. And come to this, our Fulani herdsmen or herdsmen, in fact, like she said, we don't need grazing reserve all over the state. Please, even if you put grazing reserve all over the state, the crisis will be much. Because those people, they are not the people, the kind of people that you live with them. One, they don't have religion. They don't go to school. So they don't value human life. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much for your important contribution. We would like to tell everybody when they are say, we will put small padlock for our telephone line so that we'll get the opportunity to exhaust all this particular discussion. So quick one because of time.
Make I tell you, finish quickly telling now. This year. People, they ask me, say, I can't get lots of questions. Say, you said this deal, no be deal, we negotiated from the point of strength for Nigeria. Say, which other way we don't go? Which other way we for go? You see, me, self, I go there for blame for this one. Nigerians know their rights. Average Nigerians know, say, that arbitration where they put for Obodo Ibo courts, you know, it don't trample on the rights of every Nigerian. United Nations today, make everybody Google United Nations Declaration on Indigenous People. It gives the rights of every citizen of every country the right over to enjoy their natural, God-given natural resources. And be say, no international business whatsoever. International and local business can supersede that right of the people. That means, say, you, self, let me tell you, you had the right to sue that Indian company for holding Nigeria's hostage. I can't ask the question. Me say, I be lawyer. That's why I say I shame myself, first of all, because I discovered it late. But all my senior SANs, where were they? Why did they not? They'll be chasing electoral cases, cases of election because it's having money. Where is your patriotism? Why did Nigerian Bar Association not get up and challenge the Indians to court? Why?
Natasha.
And the thing vexed me too much.
We're not going to allow you to vex too much. Issues when they affect us inside of Nigeria. We'll continue to discuss this.
We need to continue this.
On top of us, we are the only people when we say, not be auntie, their newspaper headline, go, they discuss, and we discuss and they go. And we promise you, just like we promise Nigeria, say, if you get the opportunity, come Lagos again. We will give you another time to come discuss this particular issue because anything will be the key to making Nigeria
the land of milk and honey.
We appreciate that. We go lock our shop, carry key, go, but our year go the ground. We'll come back on Monday with all the action to give you an as the hot. Madam Natasha, we'll go shake you this time with two hands.
Thank you very, very much.
Two hands, plenty of respect.
Thank you very much.
I hope to discuss more so Nigerians can know their rights and know what to stand for.
So tomorrow we'll come again. Monday we'll come again. Now, bye bye.
To enjoy more of this, our Ogbonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.